What is up, everyone? My name is Fingsia, and today I have exciting news for those of you who have been waiting for something new to have in Survarium. PVE mode is finally out, and I gotta say, it might not be what I exactly expected it to be, but it's still pretty good, and I appreciate the hard work that Vostok Games have been doing to make this happen.
Alright, let's get started. First, let's start with how to even get started in the menu. When you're in the lobby and you go to the player mode menu, you notice there's a new tab called Team Missions. After that, you can enter another menu, and from there, you can change the difficulty, search for random players, or invite some of your friends. In order to even get access and play the mode, you need at least one special key. All members of your squad need one key each in order to start. Do note that you can get 2 free keys every day if you win 2 PvP matches. When you get into the match, you have a few missions to do. If you played Combat Arms before and played their game mode called Fireteam, this mode here is kind of like that. You spawn in with your squad and go through a somewhat linear map, except in this case there's a few small side areas to explore and alternative routes to take and about 10 stashes to find. But other than that, you just kill some enemies, new quest pops up, and continue further into the map. It's not like this big map where you can do whatever you want and go around and talk to some NPCs and get some small side quests and have a main quest, which was kind of what was expected to begin with. I'm a little bit disappointed that it's not like that, but as of now, I'm just pretty happy about that we have a PvE mode, finally. We have the opportunity to explore a map and co-op with friends. The timer is another factor that I'm not all that happy with. I kind of feel like I want more time to explore, but when I think about it, the only real reason to do that would be to find more stashes. I love how they added anomalies and the bolts that you toss into the anomalies to locate where they are. It's just like Stalker. And it really shows that this game is going to be something that most Stalker fans will be happy about. They have also made a leaderboard for PvE mode showing players who have found most stashes and completed the map the shortest amount of time. The stashes seems not to be randomly placed, but they do have a preset of locations that they can spawn. I believe there's over 10 different locations. Hard mode on Tier 5 is somewhat challenging enough to keep you on your toes. But running and gunning through the map is not something I recommend, as in some situations you'll simply get killed for not being careful enough, and it sucks to wait for your teammates to get through to the next checkpoint so you can resurrect again. Sadly, there are no mutants in this map, and no NPCs that give you out other side quests or something like that, only enemies to fight. Also, I don't know if they are gonna change this in the future, keep it like this, but it seems like that in this current version of this map, that artifact equipment or equipment that gives anomaly protection in general is completely useless, given the fact that there are no artifacts anywhere to use. All the anomalies seem to be giving the same amount of damage regardless of your gear. A little side note about rewards. Naturally, the higher difficulty you play, the better rewards you'll get. And I highly recommend that you get as many stash crates as possible, as that will be where you will get your rewards from. Doesn't really matter how many kills you get, it's actually the stash crates that determines how much loot you get, and it's completely random what you can get. But on higher difficulty, you have a rare chance of winning some premium gear, which is pretty amazing. So with all of this, what could they improve? I think they should add some artifacts to the map. That might conflict with the reason why you were there to begin with. The mission is about collecting a seemingly rare artifact, so it would probably not make sense to do that so early on in the story. But I think that making anomaly protection should be more relevant. Perhaps our anomalies could do way less damage to the players with anomaly protection. Maybe give the minimap to those who have the forest sense skill that makes you able to see anomalies on a minimap. Perhaps this map is just favoring the heavy armored kind of playstyle, which is awesome because being slow is not really a disadvantage in this mod.
gear, and on harder difficulties, more protection from shots is really a welcoming thing. I like that the anomaly capsule actually works here. The anomalies completely disappear, meaning that you can open up for new and easier paths, which is really nice, since at some point in the mission, you're completely surrounded by anomalies. So it's really useful there. Scanners, traps, claymores and C4s are completely useless, or at the very least, not worth it in this case. What is however very useful, if your squad is having a hard time, is ammo crates. Even though there is an ammo crate refill at the sawmill, it's still nice to have an ammo crate when you're pinned down, which you will be very often, since you don't want to waste your life and die for nothing, since that will mean you'll have to wait for your teammates to get to the next checkpoint, or use an extra special key for an instant revive, which I think is a big waste of your keys, given the fact that you have so few of them and you can only earn 2 per day. I was a little bit disappointed that there are no mutants in this map, but I can kinda understand it since this is the first map. But especially in the laboratory after you find the air artifact and get teleported, I had the craziest stalker vibe when I first entered the dark laboratory. It made you expect that something scary was about to happen, that something was lurking in the darkness. I'm kinda sad that there was no scary mutant encounters down there, or at the very least, some enemy encounters. I think Watchdog Games missed out on a great opportunity there. But perhaps in another map we'll get exactly that. Well, that's it for me guys. Like the video if you did, subscribe for more Survarium content, and leave a comment on what you think and what your opinion was about the PvE mode. My name is Fengs here, and I see you in another video. Cheeky breeky stalkers.